Welcome back, everyone. Have you ever found yourself saying, I wish I looked a little more like her, or I wish I had what they have?
Stop trying to be as skinny, smart, or successful as them. It's time to discover how to be uniquely you.
Psychotherapist and author of Star Child, Kay Goldstein, has steps to help you live your own life and stop comparing yourself to others. Kay, good to have you here.
Thank you so much.
You say the first thing to do is to pay attention to what brings you joy and happiness.
That's right. You can tell when something gives you energy. It gives you some passion. It gives you an excitement. So it's really important to pay attention to that, because then that's giving you some clues about who you are and what really turns you on.
So almost make a list of the things that really bring you joy
and get you going. Right. And conversely, pay attention to the things that make you feel like all the air has gone out of the balloon.
Right. So things that make that feel like a chore are really things that are not in you that you love, obviously.
That's right. And there could be people, too.
Oh, absolutely. People can really bring you down or bring you up. And people who bring you up are people who are really seeing you as you are.
Right. Okay. Now, you say use your imagination. Take a few moments every day and give yourself a morning of discovery.
If you can do that, it's a wonderful way to expand the possibilities of who you are. We often only operate on a very limited part of who we are. And so if we meditate, or we write in our journal, or we take a walk in nature, or we take a class in something we've always wanted to do, we learn something about ourselves and we start using parts of ourselves that we didn't know we had.
And you open the doors to so many other things
exactly.
in your life.
Exactly.
You know, one of the hardest things to do is to stop judging yourself.
Yes, and this is really critical, because as you start discovering some things about yourself, listen for those little comments that say, I can't do that. That would be stupid. We all have those little voices in our heads.
Sure.
But if you can turn them off, it again allows you to expand the possibilities.
And when you accept yourself and your strengths and your weaknesses, does it just make you a whole lot more attractive to everybody else?
Well, it probably will, because it makes you clear. You have clarity. Anyone who has clarity, you know you can trust. If you're being authentic, then everybody can understand who you are and where you're coming from.
So basically, don't be afraid to ask for help.
Oh, absolutely. If you're asking for help, it's because you need a little bit of assistance. You want people who recognize who you are. And other people, everyone has been through this. Everyone has separated from themselves in some way. So everyone understands what you need.
Show some humility, too. Yeah.
Is it not human to always see the grass is greener over there? I want what they've got.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I think it's absolutely human. But I think if we keep coming back to, if we want to better ourselves, but if we can just be ourselves first, we can make some better choices about whether or not we want to go to that green grass or not.
Right.
So stay on the course then, just focus on yourself then. Try to avoid comparing yourself to others.
I think that's really, really important.
Let's talk about people who are unhappy and they're blaming everyone, the system, the government. They blame everybody, but they don't look at themselves.
Right. I think everyone needs to whine just a little bit every day, probably. But if you live your life always thinking that the problem is outside of yourself, then you're not looking at what you bring to the problem. And you need to take responsibility.
It's tough. Accountability.
It's tough.
But that's what it comes down to, is feeling like you don't have to be in control of everything. A lot of people want to feel like they have control of their life, every detail of their life, but that's just not possible.
It is not possible. And everyone thinks that they can do it. If they only do this, we can be perfect. We get ourselves on this sort of hamster wheel of trying to do more and more and more to be perfect, and we can't.
What about people who are stuck in a job, they can't afford to leave, but it really makes them unhappy?
Well, I think that if you get up every morning and you say, what I have to offer, my own little grab bag of skills and talents and history and personality, is worthwhile, and I have something special to offer, that changes your whole attitude for the day. And then you can begin discovering ways that you can use that in a more effective way, even outside the job.
Right, exactly. Maybe you can use it to help you get the skills to get another job or get out of that job.
Yes. But if you're in it, lots of us are in situations where we feel like we have no wiggle room.
We're stuck.
But I think that our attitude makes a huge difference about what we do every day. If we think we're valuable, then we are valuable.
Right about that. Kay Goldstein, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, still to come on Daytime, Susan Merrill from imom.com has ways to help us all get more organized this year.
Who couldn't use that?
Oh, we all could.